All right, guys, today we're going to talk about material handling and storage. Here's a startling statistic for you all to think about. 20 to 45% of occupational injuries occur when handling materials. Strains, sprains, fractures, and contusions are the most common injuries that we deal with. So we need to be sure to wear our gloves, of course, but make sure they're dry and free of grease and other chemicals. So when we lift something up, it doesn't slip out of our hand, causing a contusion or anything else. If the job can be engineered differently to reduce manual lifting, that would be the great way to approach it. Some other things to think about: can the material be moved mechanically? What hazards does the material being handled offer? You know, dust, chemical exposure, and so forth. So be sure to include these steps when lifting material either physically or with machinery on your JSA. Of course, lift with your legs, not your back. If something is too heavy, don't try to be Superman, get help. Lifts should be close to your body and centered. When handling boxes, the best way to handle them is to grasp the alternate top and bottom corners and draw one corner between the legs. So when handling sheet metal, you need to wear your leather gloves. So guys, when handling heavy switchgear, please use the rollers so we can distribute the load on there and push instead of getting all the big guys and causing back strains. Lastly, when we're handling flammables, be sure they're stored in the flammable cabinets, not in just regular storage boxes. Remember, our goal is to work safely, and that's the only way to work.